All right, next question. Coding endomyocardial biopsy done with a right heart cath. When endomyocardial biopsy, CPT code 93505, is done with the right heart cath, CPT code 93451, we only code for endomyocardial biopsy or code both with modifier 59. So she's asking which way to go. Also, where can I find more information regarding this? So I did a little research on this one, and basically what I found was a 2000 CPT Assistant article. Now, the cardiac cath codes have changed since then, but the principle of how they were answering still applies. And basically they said when an endomyocardial biopsy is performed in conjunction with a diagnostic cardiac cath, then you code the 93505. Then code 93505 should be reported in addition to the component cardiac cath codes. So they're basically saying, yeah, you can report both. However, if the physician performs the cardiac cath only as a means of obtaining the biopsy, like that was a reason for going in, then no, just code the biopsy is basically what they're saying. So it's all about really the intent. And so if the intent was to just do the biopsy, then code just that. But if they're doing the heart cath and while they're there, like, oh, that looks suspicious, I'm going to take a biopsy of it, then go ahead and report that with the modifier 59. Okay. Now, what I wanted to do is, of course, take this as an opportunity to show you how I did that research, because we like to teach you how to fish, not just give you the fish. So I'll do my little split screen here and show you how I looked this up. So I came here and I typed in, I'm trying to think what code I typed in. I think it was 93505. And I normally do a Google search and look around and just, you know, I kind of have my understanding of what I think is correct, but then I go confirm it and get some backup. So I came here and I read some of the guidelines. I looked at the plain English description because sometimes in there they'll give a clue as to, you know, that it's bundled. And I came down, I started looking in here, articles and newsletters. Now you have to have a certain level of Find a Code access to get this, or, and for CPT Assistant, you have to pay for an upgrade to get CPT Assistant, which I have. So I came here and I said, oh, there's a CPT Assistant article. And let me click that and see if that has anything I'm looking for. So I clicked on it. And sure enough, here's the question. Like I said, the cath codes are a little out of date, but this is where I got the answer. Okay? So very, very helpful. It helps you be your own consultant and, you know, answer your own questions and get backup, because what this questioner is saying, also, where can I find more information? Because they probably need to go state a case to give to their provider to tell them, this is how we should code it, this is why I feel this, this is my backup. So Find a Code makes it rather easy. And then they, I think if you have the professional level, you can, you get the decision health articles. You might be familiar with the answer book and the pink sheets. That's what I, when I first started coding in 99, had all of those books, and you'd get the paper sheets and you'd pull out the outdated ones and you'd insert the new ones. It was a lot of work. Now we've got all this wonderful automation. And they give you the little number to know if there's anything inside. So if there's nothing inside, then you don't have to, you know, expand it. So anyway, that's how I kind of did that and did some more web searching and looked around and confirmed that that was a good answer.